We're here at Lincoln Financial Field for this matchup between the Seahawks and the Eagles. We could talk about all the players out there on the field today, but our cameras will be trained on these two decorated coaches.
Yeah, and you know why? Because today we're going to have a lot of situations that are going to come up where it's going to come down to the decision of the coach. Is he going to make the right one or the wrong one? And one of the reasons why you said they're great is because they make a lot of good decisions during the game.
And Rice is going to get set in the slot for this snap.
Action fake, throws to the right.
And it's incomplete, just couldn't hold on to it after the hit.
Well, they always say if you get your hands on the football, you got to make the catch. Yeah, right. The guy that made that rule up wasn't getting hit as he was trying to catch the football. Nice hit that time by the defender.
That's second down coming up. Screen play is on. Makes the reception.
You got to be smart on the defensive side now here, third and long. Be a little careful. Maybe give up a short pass or a short run. And if they throw it short, make sure you come up and make the tackle.
Harvin's lined up in the slot. Third and 12. And the interception by Patrick Chung.
Well, it's a bad decision that time by the quarterback, and it results in an interception. When you throw one like that early in the game, it could definitely shake your confidence for the rest of the day.
Michael Vick will be under center. First and 10. McCoy is taking the handoff. And it's Earl Thomas who brought him down that time.
Well, I know it was a short run that time by the offense, but it's what it's going to do for you long term. Keep running that football. Try to wear the defense down.
It's now second down and 7 after the 3-yard rush. Quarterback, quick toss to the outside. Good piece of tackling.
That was a nice run that time by the offense, picking up those yards. And anytime you gain more than 3 yards on a running play in the National Football League, it is deemed successful.
New set of downs now after picking up the first on the ground. Staying with the running game on first down. And he's got the first down.
Nice run that time by the running back. And if they keep running the football like this, it's just a matter of time before they fake it and throw that football over the top of the defense. They are being physical. The running back doing a good job, and they are making it happen in the running game today.
Advances it out to about the 9.
Boy, after watching that long run, I'm winded. That was a nice job by the running back. Good job up front, sustaining the blocks. Offense got to be happy with that.
They're able to move the chains after that last run. McCoy's got the carry once more.
Hard to score a touchdown sometimes when you get in the red zone in the NFL. Why? Because the defense doesn't have to worry about passes down the field. The offense runs it. They are ready to get it done, and they do, and stop the offense for a short game.
offense heads to the line for the seventh play of the drive.
Catch is made. Touchdown.
Good job that time by the offense, scoring that touchdown and putting him ahead. And when you get ahead in a football game, the National Football League, it makes you relax and you play better.
The PAT sails wide here.
Alex Henry ready for the kickoff.
And he's tackled right at about the 28-yard line. Come to the line, and it's first down. Going across the middle, very nearly intercepted.
Well, when you want to put all the pressure on the quarterback to make really good throws down the field, play tight man-to-man coverage. It takes perfect throws to get completions. Not there that time.
With a nickel look here on defense. No one in sight has the grab. Touchdown.
What a terrible job by the defense. That time, nobody even covers the receiver. He is wide open down the field, and, hey, nice job by the quarterback going through his progression. He finds the open guy and gets a touchdown pass.
The Seahawks will go ahead with the extra point. Inside of the uprights. The Eagles are prepared to return the kickoff. That'll be a touchback, and the ball will be placed at the 20. McCoy's lined up as the single back. First and 10. They run the counter play. Tackled down at the 22.
Nice job that time by the defense. They were ready for the run. Nowhere for the running back to go. And they stop him for a short gain.
Quarters formation here for the defense. Looking across the middle. What a hit, and the ball is dropped.
That was a big hit by the defender that time. The receiver drops the football. I'll tell you what, I guarantee the next time he goes over the middle, he'll be looking for that defender.
After the incomplete pass, it's third down. Michael Vick will take it from the gun. And that's going to be a three and out.
All you have to do is watch the head of the receiver. When they drop footballs, usually it's because you can see their head move the other way before the football gets there. That's what happened this time, and it's a drop pass.
Harvin will return the punt. They've got him down there. The Eagles' defense now is going to go nickel. He's looking to the right here on this throw. Russell Wilson connects with Golden Tate.
That time the pass is completed into double coverage, Jim, but the quarterback made a bad read. But these receivers, they are so good nowadays. That time in double coverage, he went up and made the catch. It's like Bill Parcells said to me once about Mark Bavaro, a very talented receiver. He goes, remember, Sims, when he's covered, he's open.
Now first and 10. Down the field. And it's incomplete. They went for the deep throw, but the defensive back was there.
Yeah, good job that time. I got to give the defensive back a lot of credit. He was not caught sleeping out there. He was alert, read the right keys, and he was right with the receiver to knock down that deep throw.
This will be second down. Wide open for the catch.
I love seeing the post route against defenses that are up there being aggressive, trying to stop the run. You go down the field. How about that? Stick that foot into the ground, make that break at 10 yards, and run right down the middle of the field on that post route.
Challenging the defenders to the right side.
Incomplete.
Tight ends, second and 10. Looking for a receiver on the left side here.
The ball's deflected incomplete. Yeah, this defender probably can block a lot of shots in basketball games, too. That's just a wonderful job. Good timing, and he swats the football away for the incompletion.
Marshawn Lynch is in the backfield. End zone bound, and he's got the touchdown.
What a tough throw and catch into a tight spot right there for the touchdown. But in today's game, these players are so good that you have to throw it in traffic. They've got to make the catch. That time he did.
Add the extra point. The kick is good. Steven Hauschka ready for the kickoff.
No return. The ball's coming out to the 20.
Well, we're anxious to hear the full story on that injury. Let's go down to Danielle Bellini with the story.
Guys, I just spoke with a Seahawks official. Sounds like it's just a minor issue, and he'll be back on the field shortly.
Offense lines up here. First and 10. LeSean McCoy takes the handoff.
Good job of the defensive line standing in there and fighting, and they hold the running back to a short gain.
Second down here after that run play. Play action. Throws the pass. Oh, that could have been intercepted, but he couldn't hold on. Too much pressure on the quarterback on that play, Phil.
That defense, boy, oh boy, are they aggressive, and they can get after the quarterback. We saw it on that play. This is going to be a tough assignment for this offensive line today.
Cooper's a receiver in the slot. Vic in shotgun formation. Looking for an open receiver on the right. Incomplete. They're in punting formation. Waves his arm, and he's going to make a fair catch. They face first down. Looking to the right side and throwing. He's wide open for the grab.
Well, the corner route. Some people call it the corner route. They call it a flag, run to the flag of the end zone, or a seven route. Odd numbers break out. That time we see a nice route by the wide receiver and a good throw by the quarterback.
That reception gave them the first down. Barwin gets to him for the sack.
Well, that's a good job by the defense that time, getting the sack on the blitz. And when you blitz, you're taking a chance. You better get to the quarterback, and that time they did.
The wide receiver in motion. Working that left side. Percy Harvin with the grab.
Perfect defense call that time. They allowed the catch. The coach on the sidelines going, well, what else do you want me to do? We had the guy double covered. and you still couldn't make the play.
The Seahawks offense is still out there as we get the second quarter underway. Third down now, and the second quarter is underway with this snap.
Good job of knowing the situation on the offensive side. Third and short. Don't look for a big run. Just get enough to get a first down and get those chains moving.
First down here after the run. With two hands, he has it.
What you saw there was a good job by the wide receiver. Run that curl route and then see the quarterback, watch the ball, then attack it. Good job of getting your hands on there and making the catch.
Second and five. The throw to the left. He had it, but the hit jars the ball loose.
That's why you like defenders who are good punishing tacklers. Make those receivers worry about coming over the middle. They'll be careful the rest of this game because of that big hit.
It'll be third down. Reaches out and snatches it.
I think the best thing to say about that play, it's just it gained a few yards, so that's what you do. All plays don't score. Sometimes you just want to pick up a couple yards.
They're back at the line after that catch for a first down. Throws to the right. How did he drop that?
These receivers in the NFL, they are so good now. Anytime you see a drop pass, it's almost always the one reason. They took their eyes off the football before it got there.
The Eagles defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. Second down and 10. Throwing now to his left. Makes the catch. Touchdown.
The fade route, it's a big part of every offense now in the NFL. We see it here. Look at the receiver. Pins the defender inside. Beautiful throw to the outside. Fade for a touchdown.
Seahawks ready here for the kickoff. They're all over him at the 18-yard line.
Watch the blitz.
LeSean McCoy is in the backfield. First and 10, McCoy. Going to be a tackle for a loss.
So many things you could do on first down, and what do you come up? You come up with that play. That was just a bad play call.
That leads us to second down. Here's the give to LeSean McCoy, and that's good for only a yard or two.
Well, a short gain on the run that time by the offense. When you're running football team, listen, there's going to be a lot of ugly plays that don't work. You just got to keep running it.
Under pressure and incomplete. Donnie Jones now ready to punt. Blindly spins away from the hit.
Of course, Jim, you and I would have called a fair catch there because you know why? We're cowards. Who'd want to take this kind of punishment when the defender's all around you?
Harvin's in the slot. First down and 10. Looking for Percy Harvin. He's almost intercepted.
I think that's the hardest pass a defensive back has to defend. The long throws down the field. You have to wait to the last second to make your play. That time the defensive back did it. What a play.
And Davis is shifted out wide to the left as a receiver. It's going to be a delay of game penalty.
Offense. Still second down.
Russell Wilson has it under center. Second and 15. They're setting up screen. Tackles made.
Nice play call that time by the offensive coordinator. A little screen pass to the halfback. He knew the defensive line was going to be charging hard. They were, and it picked up some nice yards.
First and 10. And that's a big tackle behind the line of scrimmage.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the first down play that time by the offense, and now they have a good situation.
And he's forced to the ground.
This defense, they are definitely not faint of heart, are they, Jim? They will bring the pressure. Good blitz that time, and they take the quarterback down.
Harvin's lined up now as a slot receiver. Third and 20. Wilson's play action. Almost intercepted that time.
You near midfield. It's fourth down. What do you do? I got the answer right here. You punt it. Play field position. Make the other offense drive the length of the field to score.
Quarterback is coming to the line, hoping to avoid being sacked for a third time. This is going to set up a change of possession.
Well, you got to live with this decision now, big guy. You go for it on fourth and long, it fails. Probably going to give up some points because of a bad decision by you.
On first down, McCoy's going to secure the handoff. That brings the play to an end.
Good coaching on the defensive side. Everybody stays at home. They stay in their gap, and they hold that run to a short gain.
Coming up, second down. Michael Vick will take it from the gun. Looking to scramble. Ball's on the ground. And the recovery is made by the defense.
You got to protect the football on the offensive side. When you don't protect it, the way these defensive players can run, you're going to get in trouble. And that time it results in a fumble.
The defense comes out of the dime. Russell Wilson will take it from the gun. The there.
That was a terrible throw by the quarterback. When you're off target like that, you deserve to throw an interception.
Cooper is going to get set in the slot for this snap.
They've got him again.
Not a good job by the quarterback that time. Inside of 2 minutes in the first half, you got to get rid of the football. If nobody's open, just throw it away. That time, he loses yards by taking the sack.
Vic's back in shotgun formation.
This doesn't look good. We've got a player down, and he's in pain.
I think you can just tell by the body language and the way he's acting, that is an upper body injury. Hope it's not severe. We'll let you know as soon as we find out.
McCoy is shifted from running back to a receiver in the slot.
Third and forever. Right on the money.
Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field.
You just can't sit back there and play conservative defense in the NFL. The quarterbacks and receivers are too good. Third and over 10 yards, you play safe and you give up the first down. What a nice quarter route run by the wide receiver. He fakes the defense and back out. And look at the quarterback. He knows that little move. When he stuck it, he let him out to the corner. Nice throw, nice catch.
Let's see how they back up the big play here. Vic standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap.
He had unstoppable.
Jim, what a nice throw by the quarterback. Puts the football right in the hands of the wide receiver. He's behind the defense, but look at the hustle and the speed by the defense. They get the tackle from behind.
This play set up by the long gainer.
Count it. Touchdown.
Well, it's first and goal. I think a lot of defenses are thinking run here, and so the offense, they call a nice play, very deceptive. They throw the football, and they get the easy touchdown pass.
He made it. Eagles getting set for the kickoff. This big return's going to set up his team in excellent field position.
Well, a lot of good things happened on both sides of the football this time. How about that return by the return team? Good job, good blocking. Look at the speed of that guy running. They get the tackle from behind. They stop the touchdown.
Harvin's lined up in the slot. First and 10. He'll fire it out to the left.
No way that would be completed.
When you play man-to-man coverage, it takes a good throw and catch. That time, neither was there. Another incomplete pass.
Offense lines up here. Second and 10. He'll throw it over the middle. Pass is made, and it's incomplete. The hit jars the ball out. Marshawn Lynch is in the backfield. Trying to work that left side. That'll put them in what we call plus territory.
Sometimes they tell the receiver just to go long, run a fly route, run a nine route, because that means straight ahead or a streak. Show the speed that you have and get it done.
Oh. This will most likely be the final play before the half ends.
First and 10. Eyeing that left side. Catch is made.
Well, there's nothing the defense can do. When you talk about a... like these guys out there now, and this one in particular, a double coverage, they're still able to go in between the defenders, rise up, and make the catch.
That kick came right at him, and it looks like the receiving team has recovered. LeSean McCoy is in the backfield. McCoy's handed the football.
Now you know why guys like Vince Wilfork are so important to the middle of defenses. You need a big run stopper to stop these runs right up the middle. You either need a big run stopper or some really big linebackers to stop those runs up inside.
Michael Vick will be under center. Quarterback tosses it to the outside. He's brought down.
I like this. Show some patience. Don't try to get it all in one play. Pick up first downs and try to go down the field and score.
New set of downs now after picking up the first on the ground. On first down, it's back to the ground game.
What that run does, it just puts the offense in a good situation. So a good, positive run.
And it's now second down and 5 after running it on first down. Vick got the football after the play fake. Incomplete as that ball sails out of bounds. Cooper's a receiver in the slot. Vick in shotgun formation. He's looking to the right here on this throw. Touchdown and drawing close.
One thing a defense doesn't want to see, yards after the catch, yak. And that's what we saw here. The quarterback put it right on target. The receiver's running full speed, catches it, and takes it all the way for a touchdown.
Well, this works out about 40% of the time if you look back on history, and they'll go for that two-point conversion. Michael Vick will take it from the gun. And intercepted! Could have taken the one-point gimme. They went for the two, and they are turned away. The Seahawks are in shape now to return the kick. He'll have a chance to take off. The tackle's made. The offense will start their drive from about the 31. Comes out of the nickel. Will run it. Here's the handoff. Spins away from the hit. And he's brought to the ground.
When you have a defense as fast as this one, they over-pursue. So that's why you want to run a counter run. Take advantage of the fact that they are just charging too fast, too hard, and not thinking on the defensive side.
He is brought down at the 49-yard line.
That's a nice play that time by the offense, getting the first down. They're up here in the second half, and they're moving the football. That is a great feeling.
First down here after the completion. Here's the running play. Off tackle. Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field.
An off-tackle run, it's a staple of all offenses in the NFL. And a general rule is you run off the right tackle because he is the power tackle, where the left tackle is the pass blocker. The offensive coordinator's just got to make some adjustments here. They can't stop the defensive line from sacking the quarterback, so either keep the tight end in or keep the halfback in to help block for the QB.
Third and 11. This is a screen play all the way. Oh, we've got an injured player on the field.
Well, that looks like an upper body injury, Jim. I think we both can tell that. And now the question is, how bad is it? You just never know.
After the long gain, let's see what they do here. Percy Harvin with the grab.
The defense has got to be a little aggressive here. Your team is down. You've got to attack this offense. You don't want them to get in there and get another score.
Play number six coming up on this drive. First and 10. He'll fire it out to the left. That pass incomplete. Let's go now to Danielle Bellini, who has an injury update.
Guys, I just spoke with an Eagles official. The injury appears to be minor, so the trainers are just looking him over one last time, and then he'll get back on the field.
It's now second down.
Bad decision that time by the quarterback. He tries to force the football into the end zone, and it almost gets picked off by the defense.
Split backfield here. Third and 10. In his hands, complete, touchdown.
Tight ends are a position where you got to be able to do it all. You got to be able to block, run routes, and you got to be able to get in position so you have a chance to catch the touchdown pass. Good job by the tight end, touchdown.
Steven Hauschka ready for the kickoff.
Send him to the 20-yard line.
McCoy's a running back normally, but this time lined up as a receiver in the slot. Vick's got it in the gun, challenging the defenders to the right side.
Intercepted!
Most NFL linebackers, they're borderline good enough to be a running back, and they got the hands of defensive backs. Here's a good case. What a fine catch on the interception by the linebacker.
Nickel formation here for the defense.
Got a big lane.
That picks up seven.
Running backs, they love counter runs. They know when a defense has been over pursuing, so they make that fake one way, and when they cut it back, there's usually a great running lane there.
Second and two. Harvin's got it on the handoff.
Nice job that time. The run play gets the first down. You move those chains. Hey, it's kind of fun to watch a team tough enough and patient enough to run the football to get these first downs instead of throwing it all the time.
Russell Wilson has it under center. First and 10. Trent Cole gets to the quarterback.
I don't know what the quarterback was looking at. He had to know the defense was blitzing that time. Doesn't make a quick enough decision, and the defense gets there and gets the sack.
Russell Wilson hits Zach Miller with that throw.
Again, the offensive coordinator's done a terrific job so far here today. He's got his team winning. You're in the red zone. Let's see how clever he's going to be on this call.
Here's the first snap after the big play. They set up the I formation. It goes to touchdown, Seahawks.
I'd say this run by the offense is just, it's arrogance. They just say, you can't stop us. And they lined up and just shoved it down the defense's throat. Nice run there on first and goal for the touchdown.
Oh, it's a fake.
So from 2 yards out, they get it across and secure 2 extra points. The Eagles are prepared to return the kickoff. Someone's been injured out there. Hold on a minute.
That's a good job. He's able to get up and get off the field. And my guess is he's going to be okay. A little bit of a scare there, no doubt about it. That makes everybody nervous.
First down coming up. Setting up screen. Brings it in. Eagles.
Good job by the offensive coordinator calling those plays. Leads to a touchdown. They're just slowly chipping away at this lead. Now can the defense come out and help them out?
Makes the PAT. The Seahawks are set to return the kickoff. Tackles made right around the 25-yard line. The defense comes out in the nickel. First and 10. Barwin gets to him for the sack.
The offensive line did a terrible job that time reacting to the blitz by the defense. They let the defenders come free, and they sack the quarterback.
15 minutes to go. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Seahawks will come to the line trying to put together a scoring drive here in the fourth. He's setting up here. He's been sacked 5 times today. Really been beat up.
This is frustrating for a coach. You call a play, you get the receiver down the field on a corner route, and your quarterback cannot put it on the target.
Failing to connect there, third down. And the interception by Patrick Chung. He stacked up at that point.
Give a lot of credit to the defense this time. They got the offense backed up. It's inside its own 20. They're aggressive, and being aggressive gives them a chance to get the interception, and they make it. Nice play.
First down on the way. They give it to the running back. He's brought to a halt.
You got to keep your offensive lineman aggressive, so you have to run the football every once in a while. That run, even though it was a short game, it served a purpose.
LeSean McCoy is in the backfield. Clay Fox running down. It's incomplete. The defender had it for a moment, but could not pick it off cleanly. Third down. Jackson's in the slot. He's scrambling down. Long ball to DeSean Jackson.
That's what you have to do as a defensive back. You got to wait to the last second. Wait till the receiver uses his hands. And once they go up, put your hand in between them and knock that football down. What a play.
Right off the upright and wide of the mark.
So many times when you see these field goal kickers miss it, it's just about mechanics. What was it? Were the steps wrong? Did he plant his foot in the right spot? And you got to hit that football in the perfect spot, too. A little bit of everything went wrong that time.
Nickel formation for the defense here. He sends the halfback in motion.
First and 10.
Running away from the pressure.
Getting sacked.
Oh, my gosh. When you take those blindside hits, the first thing you think of as a quarterback when you get up, did somebody make a mistake or did I make the mistake not seeing that guy coming?
The Eagles come out in the nickel. Looking for an open receiver on the right. Touchdown!
You got to take advantage of situations like this. Not often in the NFL do you get somebody this wide open. Good job by the receiver. Nice job by the quarterback seeing him. And what do you get? An easy touchdown pass.
The Seahawks now lined up for the extra point. And the point after is good. Seahawks ready here for the kickoff. Fails to get out to the 20, and he is smacked down at the 15-yard line. McCoy's out in the slot, first and 10. The defense gets a sack.
Nice job that time by the defense getting the sack. The blitz was well-timed, and when it's well-timed, the offense doesn't have time to react, and they get a good sack.
Looking to the right side and throwing. Here comes the training staff as we've got a player down on the field.
Well, that's going to hurt him tomorrow. There's no doubt about it. When you get hit like that, you're going to feel some of that pain tomorrow, but the good news is I think he's going to be okay, and once he gets a little situated there, I think he'll be back in the game.
Vic's going to take the snap from the shotgun.
And he's intercepted.
That was an awesome job by the defense. They just read the quarterback's eyes. They got in position, and they made the interception.
Let's go now to Danielle Pellini, who has the injury update.
Guys, I had a chance to speak with a Seahawks team official. The injury appears to be minor, so the trainers are just looking him over one last time, and then he'll get back on the field.
Now first and 10. They hand it off to the running back. They deck him in the backfield.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the offense that time on first down. Now the defense is in a good situation.
Second down and 12.
Screen.
Just had to avoid the sack. Incomplete.
Terrible job by the offensive line. Your quarterback needs more time than that. Another incompletion.
Wide receivers are bunched up. Third and 12. And he's going to be brought down.
So many ways to overcome your quarterback getting hit and sacked. Throw the football quicker. Keep the tight end and running backs in. If you do that, he'll have time to throw it down the field.
Wilson from the shotgun. Looking long. And the interception by Patrick Chung.
Good job that time by the defense. Not being fooled. Being in position. When you're in position, you have a chance to make the play. That time they did. They got the interception.
First down here. Into the open flat. Inhales the pass. Breaks free. Has some space to work with.
Jim, this time it's a halfback screen. Nice job by the quarterback. The halfback, good job after catching it. Picked up some good yards.
First and 10. Set up screen. Nice tackle.
Find a way to score. That's always the mantra with every team when they get in the red zone. If you punch it in here, even though you're down by more than seven, it'll give you confidence for the rest of the game.
LeSean McCoy takes the handoff.
Anytime your team is down, you're inside the other team's red zone, you look for one of your star players. Your quarterback, wide receiver, or running back, they need to make a big play here.
Two-minute warning. Second down coming up. Here's the hand. He is in for the touchdown.
What a good job by the offense driving down and getting that touchdown. Even though they're still behind, they're chipping away at this lead, keeping the pressure on their opponents.
The Eagles for the extra point. Count it. They want the football back as they line up now in an onside kick formation. The onside kick is turned away and the receiving team has it. Down here.
Looking for Percy Harvin. That ball has been picked off.
That interception is strictly on the quarterback. When you make bad decisions, I don't care how good you can throw the football. The results, usually it's going to turn into an interception.
Cooper's lined up now as a slot receiver. From the gun, throws to the right where it had to be. The tackle was made.
How do you stop these receivers now? It's almost impossible with the rules of the game. Tight coverage. That time they have double coverage on him. It doesn't matter. The throw comes, they go up, they make the catch. All you can do is raise your arm and go, well, we did our best.
It's intercepted, and that's going to end the comeback attempt. Bringing the play to an end.
I have to say, that's just a terrible decision by the quarterback there. He's got to know when you're in a situation like this, you just cannot make that type of pass.
Baldwin's going to get set in the slot for this snap. First and 10. Screen pass. Brings it into his body.
Nice situation here for the offense. They're winning the football game. Now they're in the red zone. Let's see if they can come up with a play that fools the defense.
Let's see what they do on first down following that huge play. heading right, runs it in for the touchdown. That touchdown might just wrap it up.
Yeah, it sure will, Jim. It's been an exciting game all day, and it to score late in the game like this, to put it away, it's time to celebrate a little on the sideline.
No, it's not. It's a fake. You talk about momentum. That turns into an 8-point trip, the touchdown and the two.
This offense and the head coach and the offensive coordinator, they're all aggressive. So, hey, well, it's not good enough just to get a touchdown. They want to get that extra point or 2 points. Nice job that time.
And a touchback. Jackson's lined up in the slot. First down and 10. Gets away from the pressure. Taking off. Brought down at the 29.
Good job that time by Mike Vick. Nobody opened down the field, and after all these years in the NFL, this guy can still run. Nice job picking up the extra yards.
Prevent defense time. On second and one. On the run. He's looking to the right here on this throw. Has the catch, but the feet are not down.
We see it so often nowadays. All quarterbacks moving around the pocket. That time he gets outside the pocket, but as he looks down the field, nowhere to throw it, nobody open, just another incomplete pass.
Well, it was called one way on the field, but now inside of 2 minutes, it was a booth review and the call is overturned.
I think if you left it up to the coaches, they'd like to the booth to review them all, Jim, because put all the pressure on the officials in the NFL. That's what it's there for, to overturn bad calls on the field.
That pass was hurried. Avant's a receiver in the slot. Vick's going to take it from the gun. And he was wide open. They pounce on him there. Down inside the red zone now, trying to score as quickly as possible.
And listen, the defense has got to know the situation here. It's okay to give up a few yards, maybe give up a completion. Just don't give them the big play that gets the quick score.
That long gain sets them up here on this play. Challenging the defenders to the right side.
Well, the quarterback can't get him open. He threw to the right guy that time, but the coverage was so good by the defense, nowhere to get the completion.
Michael Vick backed off the line, shotgun formation. Second and goal from the six.
Good job by the defense. They are all over the throw by the quarterback. They almost pick it off in the end zone. Well, that's a big opportunity miss when you drop a pass like that.
Six. Forgot to catch the football.
Well, he dropped the football, and there's no doubt why he dropped it. You have to look it in.
This is it. Fourth and goal to go. Gets away from the pressure and complete. They fail to convert, and now a change of possession.
Quarterback should have never thrown at that time. Even though he completes the pass, he should have seen the defense was right there. A loss of a couple yards.
Not where you want to begin a series. Backed up this deep. And this will probably wrap up the game. First and 10. Looking for an open receiver on the right. They tackle him at the 26-yard line. That's it. This game is over. Well, it's a big performance in front of a primetime audience and a sweet victory in the end.